Hello and welcome in our YouTube channel Metallurgical Facts. So this is part fifth of this video series, and in this video series we are doing matching type of questions. Okay, so these matching type of questions will be beneficial for MSQ type and MSQs type of questions also. So try to learn the concept through these matching type of questions. Okay, so here in group first they have mentioned some type of corrosion, and in group second they have mentioned some examples. Okay, so this type of corrosion you must have aware about these type of corrosion, and these examples are also very common. Okay, so now we will try to match out. Okay, so first of all we need to write like that PQRS, and we need to find the odd one or the one about which we know. Okay, so the first one is that galvanic corrosion. Okay, so this galvanic corrosion is basically involves the electric current and dissimilar metals. Okay, so there are two things about this galvanic corrosion you should remember, that this galvanic corrosion involves electric current and dissimilar metals. Okay, so dissimilar metals. Okay, so this corrosion is also known as two metal corrosion basically, because two dissimilar metal take place in this type of corrosion. So this corrosion is also known as two metal corrosion. Okay, and these all are classified under the electrochemical process. That's why this corrosion is also known as electrochemical corrosion. Okay, so these are the various name of these corrosion. So these names are very important to understand the behavior of that corrosion also. Okay, because basically this galvanic corrosion happens because of the potential difference developed during the corrosion medium. Okay, so the less resisted metal acts as the anodic and more resistant metal acts as the cathodic. Okay, so that's why this galvanic corrosion is happened. Okay, so this galvanic corrosion is basically known as this galvanic corrosion is also known as two metal corrosion or electrochemical corrosion. Okay, so what is the what may be the example of this galvanic corrosion? So first one is session cracking in brass. This is not example. Nut bolt assembly with gaskets, brass fitting joined with lead tin solder. So you are saying you can see that here this is the brass, that is CuZn, and here lead tin is there, that is PbSn. Okay, so some dissimilar metal or dissimilar materials are used in this example. So that's why we can match this P, that is galvanic corrosion, by 3. Okay, so this is the 3, and the next example is filiform corrosion. The other one is stress corrosion cracking and crevice corrosion. Okay, so first of all we will see about the crevice corrosion. What is this crevice corrosion? This is basically intensive localized corrosion. Okay, so this is known as intensive localized corrosion. And this happens in the shielded area on the metal surface which is exposed to the corrosion. Okay, so this type of corrosion, this type of attack is usually associated with small volume. Okay, so small volume this corrosion take place. Okay, so for this type of corrosion is usually associated with small volume of the stagnant solutions by holes or you can say the gaskets. Okay, gaskets or surface lap joint. Okay, so these are the terms which comes under the examples of crevice corrosion. Okay, by holes, gaskets, surface lap joint, and other thing is that surface deposit you can say, and under bolt and rivet joint also. So these are the examples of this crevice corrosion. Okay, so that's why this corrosion is also known as deposit or gasket corrosion. Okay, so because this crevice corrosion basically happens within the small volume which is the result by the holes, gaskets and surface lap joints under bolt and riveting joints. Okay, so these are known as crevice corrosion. So crevice corrosion you can match by nut bolt assembly with gaskets. Okay, so this is the simple example. So crevice you can match by two. Okay, so now there are two, that is filiform corrosion and stress corrosion cracking. Okay, so what is this filiform corrosion? This filiform corrosion is basically a type of this crevice corrosion. Okay, and this happens, this filiform corrosion happens under the potential, under the protective films. Okay, so this happens in the protective films, that is under protective films. Okay, so or you can also say that the other name for this filiform corrosion is under film corrosion, or so this examples of these filiform corrosion is happens in the food and beverage cans. Okay, so these are the examples where this filiform corrosion may attack, because these are protected by some other layers, like this will be painted, or this will be enameled. Okay, this will be coated with the other surfaces, like tin, gold, AgAu, okay, and other phosphates. You can understand that, because this filiform corrosion occurs under the protective film, so that's why this is known as filiform corrosion, and this example is food and beverage cans. Okay, so for filiform corrosion Q4, you can match this filiform corrosion by painted food cans. Okay, because here this food cans are painted by some enamels, so that's why this filiform corrosion will take place. And one of the good example for this filiform corrosion is that aluminium foil which we use in our home. Okay, so that aluminium foil will also occur by this filiform corrosion. Okay, so sometimes you will find that red and brownish color on that aluminium foil. Okay, so that is basically filiform corrosion. Okay, so the next is stress corrosion cracking, basically SCC. Okay, in shorts they may ask SCC. Okay, so try to remember this abbreviation also. Okay, so this stress corrosion cracking is basically happens when the tensile stress and corrosion environment is present. Okay, so this stress corrosion cracking may happen in so the best example for this stress corrosion cracking is Sisson cracking in brass. Okay, so this is CuZn, and this Sisson cracking is basically a result of stress corrosion cracking, which involves the tensile stresses and the corrosion medium. Okay, so R you can match by 1. So you have code now 3, 4, 1, 2. So the options which is starting other than 3 you can cross. So A option is wrong, D option is wrong. We have C and B. So C contains 3, 4, 1, 2, but B contains 3, 1, 4, 2. So this is also wrong. C is correct. Okay, so C is correct answer. So the next matching is here. So match the alloy names. So alloy names is given in group first, and some main elements given in the group second, which consists by this alloys. Okay, so we need to match this alloy with the main element present in that alloys. Okay, so PQRS we will write, and we'll try to find the odd one or the common one about which we know. So suppose here Mohn's metal is the option which I know here. Okay, so this Mohn's metal, I already told you this Mohn's metal basically contains copper and zinc. This is basically a type of brass, or this is also known as alpha beta brass. Okay, so the composition of this Mohn's metal basically consists 60-40 copper Zn. Okay, but suppose if they will not give the percentage, then this Mohn's metal you can match by copper zinc alloys. Okay, so this copper zinc alloy you can match by Mohn's metal, that is 3. But in case of brass, that copper zinc ratio will be 60-70-30. Okay, so this is the main difference between Mohn's metal and the brass only. Okay, so this is also known as brass, but this is known as alpha beta brass. Okay, so the next is Babbitt metal, you can say, and the other one is Inver and Inconel. Okay, so Inver is basically easy to remember, because this Inver is alloy of FeNi, that is iron and nickel. Okay, so this FeNi some 64-36 ratio is there. Okay, so this FeNi alloy is known as Inver alloys. So Inver you can match by 1, that is R you can match by 1. The next one is Babbitt metal and Inconel. Okay, Inconel. So now you can cross check whether you are going right or not, because you can say that you can see in option D that we have our Q in 3 and R you are matching by 1. Okay, and other are not matching. Okay, so the next thing is that, suppose if you don't know about these two, so you can cross all the options from here also. You can eliminate the options because now you found your answer. And suppose if you want to cross check your answer, you can go further. Okay, so the option is other is bevit metal. So bevit metal is basically alloy of copper, tin and Sb. Okay, so some amount of Sb also presents in copper tin alloys, so that's why this is known as bevit metal. So bevit you can match by 4, and the next one is in colon, this is the wide basically there are wide elements present in the incolon, but they all will contain nickel and chromium in some amount. Okay, so this is nickel and chromium must be contained by this inconal alloy. Okay, so other elements may be iron, okay, titanium, molybdenum, columbium, all these. Okay, so S you can match by 2 because here Ni chromium is here and Fe is here, so we can match by 2. So we have code now 4321. So options which is starting other than 4 you can cross. So B option is wrong, A option is wrong. Now we have C and D. So C is 43, C is 4123, but we have code 4321, so this is also wrong. So D is correct here. Okay, so D part is correct. So next matching is the operations which is listed in group first, and the type of processes listed in the group second. So this is very nice matching from extractive metallurgy part. Okay, so blast furnace iron making. This blast furnace iron making basically a reduction process, and you can say this is the smelting process. Okay, so blast furnace is basically used for smelting purpose by using the coke as a reducing agent. Okay, so blast furnace you can match by smelting, that is 3. BOF steel making is refining, for refining, because we reduce the carbon percentage by utilizing oxygen, by doing the lancing of oxygen. So that BOF steel making you can match by refining. The next one is the Hall Herald process. So I had told you whenever you will call this name, you will call like that Hall Herald electrolysis process. Okay, this Hall Herald electrolysis process is basically involves in the extraction of aluminium. Okay, and the next one is Bayer's process. So whenever you will take the name of Bayer process, please try to take like that Bayer's leaching process. Okay, so that you can match easily. So this Hall Herald process is electrolysis process, and Bayer's process is leaching process, that is utilized in extraction of aluminium. Okay, so these two are utilized for aluminium extraction. So these in combined form. Okay, so Hall Herald process you can match by electrolysis. So R you can match by 2. Bayer's process, that is leaching, because Bayer's leaching process. Okay, so 4. So the next code is 3124. So options which is starting other than 3 you can cross. So A is wrong, C is wrong. Now we have B and C. So B and D, sorry. So B is 3124. So this is correct. D is 3142. So this is wrong. Okay, so B option is correct here. So now you got how to do the matching type of questions in exams. So this is the exam. This is the nice question you should remember for next upcoming questions. Okay. So the next matching is easy matching, but sometimes people do the mistake. Sometimes they forget. That's why I choose this matching, this easy matching. Okay. So some elements are in group first and corresponding crystal structures are in group second. Okay. So you need to match these elements by those crystal structures. Okay. So first of all, there are tungsten. Okay, and we have SCP, simple cubic, and BCC and FCC. So I will tell you here that what are the example of SCP metals. So SCP metals are basically zinc, cadmium, magnesium, titanium. So these are the example of this SCP metal. Okay, and the next one is that BCC. So BCC you can match BCC. For BCC examples are alpha Fe, tantalum, chromium, tungsten, niobium. Okay, so these all are the example of BCC. And for FCC you can say that gold, AgAu, that is silver, gold, copper, nickel, okay, and aluminium. So these are the few examples of these SCP, BCC and FCC. and very 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 few examples are known as a simple cubic, and one of that is alpha polonium, that is polonium. Okay, so this is the sum, odd one or the unique one here, that is polonium. So S you can match by simple cubic, that is 2. And here you can say that if you don't know about these other three, then also you will able to choose the option, because there are no options containing S is equals to 2. Okay, so that's why you can cross every option, you can eliminate every option, and you can go for B option. Okay, but for the cross checking you can go through your concepts. Like for magnesium you can match by SCP, that is R1. Okay, and nickel is FCC. I already told you in example here. Okay, so nickel FCC, so Q is 4, and tungsten is BCC. Okay, so P3. So this is the code 43412, and the options which is starting other than 3 you can cross here. So A and C is wrong. D option is 3 4 3 4 2 1, but this is not correct, because R means magnesium cannot be simple cubic. Okay, and the polonium cannot be SCP, so this is wrong. So B option is correct here. Okay, so this is the way of doing matching questions. Thank you guys for your attention. Hope you understood every concept behind the matching type of questions told in this video, and hope I will try to add more and more videos of matching type of questions under this video series. And subscribe our channel and press bell icon to get notifications for upcoming videos. Thank you.